Welcome to Implementing Hybrid Scenarios with Office 365 and SharePoint Server 2013. This is Module 2.4, Server-to-Server Authentication and Trust. The benefits of a hybrid SharePoint environment and the need to configure the hybrid identity management infrastructure were discussed in earlier modules. This module discusses how to configure the hybrid identity management infrastructure. The previous modules discussed the preparation of the infrastructure itself and the configuration of directory synchronization with single sign-on. The content in this module assumes you understand the need for and benefits of single sign-on, you have met the basic deployment requirements for a hybrid SharePoint environment, you have established the authentication topologies and related infrastructure, and you have configured the on-premises and online environments. This section in Module 2.4, Server-to-Server Authentication and Trust, reviews the configuration and prerequisites for infrastructure and single sign-on. It then gives an overview of server-to-server trust and provides steps for configuration. This module finishes with a discussion of the authentication and authorization flow. Single sign-on gives users seamless authentication, authorization, and access across SharePoint Server on-premises and SharePoint Online. In modules 1.1 and 2.1, we discuss the benefits of a hybrid SharePoint environment and the need to configure hybrid identity management infrastructures. In this module, we discuss configuring server-to-server trust. Later modules in this course discuss building on this infrastructure. These topics were discussed in detail in Module 2.1, Hybrid Environment Infrastructure, configuring the on-premises security token service, establishing a federated trust, installing updates for Microsoft Cloud Services subscriptions, creating or acquiring certificates, configuring SharePoint Server 2013, configuring SharePoint Online, and lastly, configuring a reverse proxy device. This diagram illustrates the single sign-on architecture. Directory synchronization without single sign-on copies users, contacts, and groups from your local on-premises Active Directory to Windows Azure Active Directory, but it does not provide a seamless authentication experience. After authenticating in one environment, when a user attempts to access a resource in another environment, they must re-authenticate. Also, passwords are stored in both locations and password policies are managed in both places. Consider activating directory synchronization as a long-term commitment to coexistence scenarios between your on-premises Active Directory and the cloud. After you have activated Active Directory synchronization, you can edit only synchronized objects by using the on-premises applications. After you've activated directory synchronization, you can only edit synchronized objects by using your on-premises Active Directory management tools. You should determine whether you require directory auditing to capture events such as creating users, resetting passwords, and adding users to groups. This section now provides an overview of server-to-server trust. User authentication in SharePoint 2013 is the process that verifies the identity of a user who requests access to a SharePoint web application. An authentication provider issues the authenticated user a security token that encapsulates a set of claims-based assertions about that user and is used to verify a set of permissions that are assigned to that user. User authorization in SharePoint 2013 is the process that determines the users who can perform defined operations on a specified resource within a SharePoint web application. The app authentication and server-to-server authentication features of SharePoint 2013 require claims-based authentication. Because of this, claims-based authentication is the default for new web applications in SharePoint 2013. When you create a web application in central administration, you can only specify authentication methods for claims-based authentication. Although Windows Classic Mode authentication is still available in SharePoint 2013 and can be configured through Windows PowerShell, we recommend that you use claims-based authentication. Windows Classic Mode authentication is deprecated in SharePoint 2013. SharePoint 2013 extends OAuth to implement a server-to-server authentication protocol that can be used by services such as SharePoint 2013 to authenticate other services such as Exchange Server 2013 or Link Server 2013, or services that are compliant with a server-to-server authentication protocol. SharePoint 2013 has a dedicated local server-to-server security token service that provides server-to-server security tokens that contain user identity claims to enable cross-server authenticated access. These user identity claims are used by the other service to look up the user against its own provider. A trust established between the local security token service and other server-to-server compliance services, such as Exchange Server 2013 or Link Server 2013, is the key functionality that makes server-to-server possible. For on-premises deployments, you configure the JavaScript object notation metadata endpoint of the other server-to-server compliance service to establish this trust relationship. For online services, an instance of the Windows Azure Access Control Service acts as a trust broker to enable cross-server communications among the three types of servers. The new server-to-server security token service in SharePoint 2013 issues access tokens for server-to-server authentication. In SharePoint 2013, trusted identity providers that are compliant with the WS Federation protocol are supported. However, new server-to-server security token service in SharePoint 2013 performs only the functionality that enables temporary access tokens to access other services such as Exchange Server 2013 or Link Server 2013. The server-to-server security token service is not used for user authentication and is not listed on the user sign-in page. The authentication provider UI in central administration or in the people picker in SharePoint 2013 products. The app authentication process in SharePoint 2013 uses OAuth to verify a claim that an app makes and assert that that app can act on behalf of an authenticated user. In SharePoint 2013, an instance of the Windows Azure Access Control Service acts as the app identity provider. You can also use app authentication without Access Control Service. The authorization process verifies that an authenticated app has permission to perform a defined operation or to access a specified resource. OAuth is an open protocol for authorization. OAuth enables secure authentication from desktop and web applications in a simple and standard way. OAuth enables users to approve an application to act on their behalf without sharing their usernames and passwords. For example, it enables users to share their private resources or data that are stored on one site with another site, without users having to provide their credentials. OAuth enables users to authorize the service provider, in this case SharePoint 2013, to provide tokens instead of credentials to their data that is hosted by a given service provider. Each token grants access to a specific site, for a specific resource, and for a defined duration. This enables a user to grant third-party site access to information that is stored with another service provider without sharing their username and password and without sharing all the data that they have on SharePoint. Server-to-server authentication allows for servers that are capable of server-to-server authentication to access and request resources from one another on behalf of users. Servers that are capable of server-to-server authentication run SharePoint 2013, Exchange Server 2013, Link Server 2013, Azure Workflow Service, or other software that supports the Microsoft Server-to-Server protocol. Server-to-server authentication enables a new set of functionality and scenarios that can be achieved through cross-server resource sharing and access. To provide the requested resources from another server that can perform server-to-server authentication, the server that runs SharePoint Server 2013 must do the following. Verify that the requesting server is trusted. To authenticate the requesting server, you must configure the server that runs SharePoint 2013 to trust the server that is sending it requests. This is a one-way trust relationship. Or, verify that the type of access that the server is requesting is authorized. To authorize the access, you must configure the server that runs SharePoint 2013 for the appropriate set of permissions for the requested resources. Note that the server-to-server authentication protocol in SharePoint 2013 is separate from user authentication and is not used as a single sign-in authentication protocol by SharePoint users. The server-to-server authentication protocol, which uses OAuth, does not add to the set of user sign-on protocols such as WS Federation. There are no new user authentication protocols in SharePoint 2013. The server-to-server authentication protocol does not appear in the list of identity providers. Your choice of an authentication topology will determine how you configure your certificates and the capabilities of your hybrid solution. A one-way outbound hybrid authentication topology enables hybrid service integration in one direction only. In this topology, your on-premises SharePoint 2013 farm can consume content and resources from your Office 365 tenant. For example, Search can be configured to allow federated users to see both local and remote search results in SharePoint 2013 Search, but only local results in SharePoint Online Search. A one-way outbound hybrid topology can only be used for outbound search solutions. A one-way outbound topology does not support hybrid solutions for business connectivity services, SAP with Duet Enterprise Online, or bidirectional search. A one-way inbound hybrid topology enables SharePoint Online to connect to SharePoint 2013 through a reverse proxy device. For example, users of a SharePoint Online search portal can see both local and remote search results, but only local results are available in the SharePoint 2013 search portal. A one-way topology can be configured to let your users access on-premises SharePoint search results from the internet as long as they have access to the intranet through a virtual private network or direct access. A two-way topology enables bidirectional hybrid service integration between your on-premises SharePoint 2013 farm environment and your Office 365 tenant. For example, Search can be configured to allow federated users to see both local and remote search results in either SharePoint 2013 or SharePoint Online search portals. A two-way topology can be configured to let your users access on-premises SharePoint search results from the internet as long as they have access to the intranet through a virtual private network or direct access. To configure server-to-server authentication for hybrid environments, you have to establish a trust relationship between your on-premises SharePoint 2013 farm and your SharePoint Online tenant in Windows Azure Active Directory. After you establish that relationship, both SharePoint 2013 and SharePoint Online trust the security tokens issued by Windows Azure Active Directory, and SharePoint Online is registered as a high-trust application in SharePoint Server 2013. The security tokens are used by authentication services both in SharePoint 2013 and SharePoint Online to grant access to SharePoint resources on behalf of federated users. This section in Module 2.4, Server-to-Server Authentication and Trust, provides an overview of configuring server-to-server authentication. When you set up server-to-server authentication for hybrid environments, you create a trust relationship between your on-premises SharePoint farm and your SharePoint Online tenant, which uses Azure Active Directory as a trusted token signing service. The process of configuration of server-to-server authentication includes installing online service management tools on a web server in your SharePoint 2013 farm, configuring the security token service in SharePoint 2013, which entails creating the new security token service certificate and replacing the default security token service certificate on each server in your SharePoint 2013 farm, and lastly, configuring server-to-server authentication. To continue, you need to install these on an on-premises SharePoint 2013 web server. The configuration tools to be installed on your on-premises SharePoint Server 2013 web server include the Microsoft Online Services Sign-In Assistant, the Azure Active Directory module for Windows PowerShell, and the SharePoint Online Management Shell. In this step, you'll load the modules you've downloaded so you can use them in your Windows PowerShell session. In this step, you'll define six variables: the root domain name of your public domain, such as adventureworks.com, the internal URL of your on-premises primary web application, the converted URL of your on-premises primary web application, the SharePoint Online application principal ID, the context ID of your SharePoint Online tenant, and lastly, the URL that is used by your Windows Azure Active Directory proxy to connect to your Windows Azure Active Directory tenancy. Replacing the default security token service certificate in the SharePoint 2013 on-premises farm was covered in Module 2.3, Hybrid Environment Infrastructure. However, important to note is that you must specify values for the start and end date in the final command in the format of month, day, and year. The start date value should be the current date, and the end date value should be the security token service certificate expiration date. However, if you are using a trial Office 365 subscription for testing, the end date value must be set to a date prior to the trial subscription's expiration date, otherwise the command will fail. The wildcard value for your public root domain name enables SharePoint Online to verify connections with any host in that domain, which is useful if you ever need to change the host name of your external endpoint or your SharePoint 2013 web application in the future. The expected validation output is a current list of SPNs for the SharePoint Online principal object of your Office 365 tenant. One SPN should appear that contains your public root domain name preceded by the SharePoint Online application principal ID. The expected validation output is a description of the registered application principal with the name of SharePoint Online. Specify the farm authentication realm value. You must now update the setup scripts with this new value. Because you have now configured this SharePoint farm to participate in a hybrid configuration, the SharePoint farm authentication realm value must always match the tenant context identifier. If you change this value, the farm will no longer participate in hybrid functionality. SharePoint 2013 will use the Azure Active Directory proxy in Azure Active Directory to sign user authentication tokens and to authenticate tokens from SharePoint Online. This section in Module 2.4, Server-to-Server Authentication and Trust, provides an overview of the authentication and authorization flow. In Step 1, if a user is not logged in, the logon prompt appears. If the user is logged in, that will initiate single sign-on. In Step 2, SharePoint detects that a request is for an app in SharePoint Online. It requests the security token service to create and sign the context token with the context information. This context token can be used later, for example by contoso.com, to request an access token from Access Control Services. The contoso.com server can then use the access token to talk back to SharePoint if the contoso.com app wants to make a web service call to SharePoint later. In Step 3, the signed context token is signed with a client secret that only Access Control Services and the contoso.com app share. In Step 4, when SharePoint renders the page, it also passes the context token to the iframe. In Step 5, the context token is included in the browser request that is sent to the contoso.com server. In Step 6, the token is signed with a client secret that only contoso.com and Access Control Services share. Contoso.com can validate that the token is really intended for it and that it's not a random request from a random server. It knows that it's part of a SharePoint request. If Contoso.com wants to talk back to SharePoint, there is a refresh token in the context token that Contoso.com can extract, so that it can include that information in the request to Access Control Services for an access token. Contoso.com then uses the refresh token that it extracted from the context token that it got from SharePoint, and its credentials to request an access token from Access Control Services so that it can talk back to SharePoint. In Step 7, Contoso.com can cache this access token. That way, the Contoso.com server doesn't have to ask Access Control Services for an access token every time that it talks back to SharePoint. By default, access tokens are good for a few hours at a time. Each token is specific to the user account that is specified in the original request for authorization and grants access only to the services that are specified in that request. Your app should store the access token securely, because it is required for all access to a user's data. In Step 8, Contoso.com can use the access token to make a web service call or a client-side object model request to SharePoint, passing the OAuth access token in the HTTP authorization header. In Step 9, SharePoint then returns the information that Contoso.com requested to Contoso.com. And lastly, in Step 10, the Contoso.com app renders the iframe contents as per user request in Step 1. This completes the OAuth transaction process. The user now sees the SharePoint page fully rendered. In this module, we discuss server-to-server trust, authentication, and authorization flow. In Module 3, we'll discuss workload considerations in hybrid SharePoint environments.